Hey, it's Jess, and I wanted to share this awesome Costco haul that I'm incredibly proud of. I really just looked around, I had a very small list, and I found a bunch of cool holiday deals, little sale things that I wasn't expecting to get, because everybody knows that's what happens when you go to Costco. So I try to avoid going there as much as possible. So I actually sent a photo of this haul to my friend and asked her how much she thought I spent, and she said around maybe $300, because I do usually only take one grocery bag full of Costco groceries, but today I got two. It's under $100, which is really incredible considering I got, you know, organic stuff, I got alcohol, I got seafood, and that was really cool and I'm really proud of it. So let's go over the haul. Over here I got a pack of organic frozen mangoes, which is our all-time favorite smoothie fruit. When I go look at all of the frozen fruit, it actually happens to be the cheapest per pound. I also got this organic ginger root, and a lot of my friends don't like to buy it at Costco because they like to pick out their ginger, but I like to just get it because I make tea or ginger beer with the crusty ones that aren't so good for stir fry. Think of garlic, don't at me with the pre-mince, but it does store better where I live. Garlic and ginger are best friends, if you didn't know that already. I got another package of the Grillo pickles, which I think might be the best store-bought pickles I've ever had. The only thing is I hate this packaging. You can see how wet it is right now. When you open this package, the pickle juice just goes everywhere. And the last one I bought made a huge nasty mess in my fridge, so I'm actually gonna open this up and put it into another container so I can avoid that this time. I have this salami trio was on sale. It was $3 off. I don't know how much it actually was because when I go to Costco, I just buy whatever I want without really taking into account how much it costs, which is very bad. But I actually prefer to buy cured meats in their whole form and cheeses too because they keep longer. So we got Italian dry, peppered, and sopressata, which I think Columbus brand sells like a cut version of it. But I just prefer the whole version because it lasts longer. This prosciutto di Parma was also on sale. It was only $8 for this thing. We have a holiday recipe that we like that comes from Max's mom. She got it from some magazine where we do green beans with some crisp prosciutto and pine nuts. It is awesome and I highly recommend that you try it. Leave a comment if you want me to make a video featuring that recipe. I got a tub of yogurt. This is the first tub of yogurt I've bought in maybe 2 years because I usually make my own yogurt from the Instant Pot, but I went on vacation and my yogurt smelled like alcohol and that was very scary, so I had to throw it away. I also got this hot smoked salmon, which was very much of an impulse buy. It was on sale for $4 off, and here's a little Costco hack. So sometimes Costco products will be an each price, sometimes it'll be a dollar off, and sometimes it's by pound. So this particular item happened to be priced per pound, and it has a little thing right here based on weight. So this item was $11.54, but it was $4 off taken at the register. So I chose the smallest one to get the best price, which is opposite, because usually you try to get the biggest thing, but in this case, the smallest one is better. So this was a total impulse buy, but I'm down to try it, and I think we might try to make that TikTok sushi bowl thing, which sounds really good, and I didn't have any salmon, so here we go. Got the classic big old bananas, conventional, not organic. We're just gonna use these for smoothies. They will probably go brown before we eat them, which is perfect. Got this goat milk hand cream, which I think is a clearance item. It's like under $10 for the set. I like to keep these in my desk at work because I work at a hospital and I have to wash my hands a lot, and the sanitizer and the hand washing does a number on my hands, so I have to keep some nice thick cream. Got good old Ménage à Trois. This is like the best red wine to bring for people who you don't know what they like because everyone is okay with it and it is pretty affordable. It's like $6 for a bottle. I actually forgot to go over this Flybird Grapefruit Paloma. It says it's a wine cocktail, which is weird because Palomas are usually tequila cocktails, but this was on sale for $9.99 for 1.5 liters. So this is, it says it equals 2 bottles, which is a lot. And Paloma is my favorite like going out cocktail, so I figured it was a good idea or worth trying. And I think this store is a little better than like multiple bottles of things. The classic giant thing of spinach, we use this for smoothies. Sometimes I like to do kale because it's a little more, it's less perishable, but I don't care so much with smoothies because when this starts to get soft, I just put the whole thing in the freezer. It says like don't freeze, but it's fine. Just like put the crinkly bits of spinach in the smoothie and it's fine. I got a thing of King's Hawaiian rolls. I actually do not like these, which is weird because I'm Filipino and they love these as well as pandesal, which I also don't like. I just don't like sweetbreads, but Max loves these for turkey sandwiches. Another thing that we do with these is sometimes, like during the pandemic when we had no options, I just covered these with like sugar and milk and made it like a little makeshift donut, which is really bad for you, but if you need a donut and you have nothing, it is an option. Thanks for sharing my haul with me, and thank you for 200 subscribers. Like, wow, I don't even think I know 200 people. So, you know, it means a lot to me, each and every one of you, and I read all of your comments. So thank you for following me on my little grocery hunting adventure. And I just wanted to thank you for all the reviews and sweet comments. Thanks and keep on cooking.